Hi, my name is Rick. สวัสดีครับโอเค for those who are collecting หลวงพ่อปีนัสแซมิวเลอร์ I believe you have actually heard of me or personally seen me before. Okay, I'm based in Singapore. I have customer from Singapore, Malaysia, China, Hong Kong, and even places like India and Mauritius as well as UK. Okay, so today I'm going to delve into what Long Paul I'm endorsing. Okay, or rather today I'm going to share with you some common question which my customer or fellow friends will ask me. Okay, number one on the list is, hey Rick, how to make my amulet powerful? Okay, so first of all, I always believe if you want to if you even before you collect any amulet, you have to first of all fine tune your mindset. Okay, we must understand that amulet has been chanted by the monk or master, okay, to protect and bless us. Okay, so having said that, okay, we have to do the work ourselves. Okay, you cannot expect sitting down at home and expecting money to drop down. Okay. Or overnight become a millionaire or billionaire. It does not work that way. Okay. So mindset very important. Secondly, will be devotion. Everyone, I believe, has a Kuba Achan, which is a mentor teacher. Okay. You may have seen that or you never seen them before. Okay. So having a mentor teacher and remember his teaching is important. So it's also even more important to respect and honor him. All right. So to be devoted, you have to actually remember his teaching and help to spread the good teaching to fellow amulet collector as well as your brother and sisters or people close to you. Okay, so third will be to chant daily. So some brothers or sister will actually ask, I don't even know how to, what it means or what it represents. Is there a need to actually chant the kata? Okay, I have to emphasize to you, in order to have a strong amulet, that is able to assist you daily on a day-to-day basis, you have to chant kata, because you must understand that a kata is there for a reason. Okay, it's not for fun sake. So we have to chant so that it can help us to bond with our amulet, especially those who are wearing spirit-based amulet, which contain bones, flesh, or naman prai. Okay, so all the more you need to chant, because it will help you significantly to bond with the spirit, and then when it comes for any obstacle or any difficulty, it will be able to help you more efficiently and promptly. Okay, so the fourth point which I need to touch on will be the tambun, which is merit making. This one I think is common, everyone always keep hearing. So tambun is actually to do good action to help someone in need. So some of the tambun, it can be to offer offering to monk. Okay, this is actually one of the tambun method, which is to offer sangkatan. Okay, the other tambun can include saving lives, which is to life releasing. Okay, like buying fishes, tortoise, or any other animals, you actually help them, save them, releasing them back to the natural habitat. Okay, this is actually a really good merit making. So by doing that, after that, you need to do your proper dedication to the amulet or your Kuba Achan. They will actually receive it, and therefore it will make your amulet even more stronger. Okay, so the fifth point and last but not least is to repeat the whole step from first to the last. Okay, so always remember to follow this step. Okay, after a while you will feel that your life will significantly improve, your luck will continue to come, will come to you, and good opportunity will open up for you. Okay, so today I think I have shared five great important points to making your amulet powerful. I hope you actually can learn something. So I hope you can support me so that I can make more content in future. Please like and subscribe to my channel. Okay, I will see you in my next video. โอเคขอบคุณครับสวัสดีครับ